Magog and I. My brother Tom had two dogs. Poppy, a red dog, which he found starving in the streets of Kabul, and Magog, a white spaniel. Poppy had no use for small boys, but Magog made himself my protector and showered all his affection on me. He was big enough to carry me for short distances. It was Magog who taught me not to pass close to dense forest cover in which wild animals might be sleeping. He could walk as noiselessly through the jungle as a cat. One morning, Magog and I set out to try to bag a peafowl. The jungle through which the road ran was the haunt of leopards and tigers. I loaded my gun. Magog and I set off on the game track. A number of jungle fowls and several peafowls crossed the track in front of us, but I could shoot none of them. After about half a mile, we came to an open glade, and as we stepped out on it, seven peafowls in a single file crossed at its other end. Waiting for a few moments, we crept forward to where the birds had crossed, and then I sent Magog to chase them up. When peafowls are chased by a dog in thick jungle, they fly and sit on branches of trees, and as I was at the stage when even a sitting bird was difficult to shoot, it could take Magog's and my combined efforts to bring down a peafowl. Magog loved to put peafowls up on the trees and dashed around barking at them. While he kept them on the trees, I would try to shoot them down. The seven peafowls, however, did not fly, but took to their legs. Magog chased them and entered at least 100 yards into the dense bushes and trees. Suddenly, I heard the squawks of the peafowls, followed immediately by a frightened yelp from Magog and the angry roar of a tiger. The peafowls had led Magog onto a sleepy tiger. All of them were expressing their surprise, fear, and resentment in their own way. Magog, after his first yelp of fear, was barking furiously and running, and the tiger was roaring and chasing him, and both were coming towards me. In the general confusion, a peacock, giving its alarm call, came sailing through the trees and alighted on a branch just above my head. My only desire at that moment was to go somewhere far away where there were no tigers. Magog had four legs to carry him over the ground, whereas I had only two. So, without any feeling of shame for deserting a faithful friend, I picked up my feet and ran as I had never run before. Magog soon overtook me. The roaring behind us was left behind. I can picture the tiger now. I could not do so at that time. Sitting in the open glade and laughing, a tiger's laugh, at the sight of a big dog and a small boy running for their dear lives, while all that he was doing was to shoo away a dog that had disturbed his sleep.